So I've been trying to convince you that finding the LU decomposition of a matrix, which is essentially Gaussian elimination, is going to take a lot longer than the solution of LU x equals b. So to solve ax equals b using a Gaussian elimination for many right-hand sides b is very inefficient. What you should do is you should first find the LU decomposition of A and then solve LU x equals B by forward and backward substitution. So to convince you that that's the case, we calculated the number of operations required to do the LU decomposition, which was Gaussian elimination. That went like 1/3 n cubed, where n was the matrix was n by n. Now let's count the number of operations required to do forward or backward substitution. They both will take the same number of operations. One is forward, one is backwards. But so we'll do it for backward substitution and then multiply by 2. That would be the number of operations required to solve LU x equals b. So this is our upper triangular matrix. So here we're going to do back substitution. We have our vector we're trying to find, and we have our right-hand side here. So you solve this problem by looking at the ith row here. You divide through by 1aii, the multiplier, and then you have bi on the right-hand side. And you throw all the other values of x that are known onto the right-hand side. So you can write down an analytical expression. And if you were going to program backward substitution, you would use this expression to program it. MATLAB does it for us, so we never actually have to program this. OK, so if we want to count the number of operations, here we have n. Minus I multiplications, and then another multiplication here if we include that. So we have n minus I plus 1 multiplications and also additions together, right? So that's for each element of each row I, and then we have n such rows. So the number of operations for backward substitution would be equal to then the sum from I equals 1 to n of this n minus I plus 1. Okay, what does this look like? When I is equal to 1, this is just n. When I is equal to 2, this is n minus 1. And it goes all the way down to when I equals n, it's 1. So it's just the Gaussian's child's play, how to sum this. This one we just write as the sum from k equals 1 to n of k. That's one of our formulas. This is 1/2 n times n plus 1. Okay? So this goes like 1/2 n squared. So that's the leading order term here, 1/2 n squared. So if we did both backward and number of operations for both backward and forward substitution, backward, B-A-C-K, plus forward substitution, it would go like twice 1/2 n squared, so it would go like n squared. Okay? Remember the number of operations for Gaussian elimination or LU decomposition goes like 1/3 n cubed. Okay? How do we compare these two? So for instance, if n was 1,000, so you have a 1,000 by 1,000 matrix, 1,000 equations and 1,000 unknowns, then LU decomposition would take 1,000 divided by 3 longer. So it would take about 300 times longer to do a 1,000 by 1,000 matrix by solving LU decomposition every single time than just doing it once and then always solving the subsequent equations using forward and backward substitution. Okay, so 300 times, that's a big number. If it was a 10,000 matrix, a 10,000 by 10,000 matrix, it would take 3,000 times longer. Okay, that's a big deal. So let me summarize. By counting operations, I've shown you that the solution of LUX equals B using forward and backward substitution is significantly faster than the solution of AX equals B using a full Gaussian elimination. This is particularly true when the matrices are full. So when A has no zeros in it, a full matrix. If A has a lot of zeros, then it's not as bad as I've said here. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.